What up, PTC? Great day to be a Reds fan. Not only did the Reds sweep a three-game set from the Brewers, go 8-10 at their home stand with a sweep over the World Series champion St. Louis Cardinals, 12-time All-Star, 1995 MVP, first 30-30 shortstop in Major League Baseball history, 9 Silver Slugger Awards, 3 Gold Gloves, 1990 World Champion, 1993 Roberto Clemente Award winner, 4-time Reds MVP Barry Larkin, enshrined into the Hall of Fame today. Listening to Barry Larkin being enshrined into the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown today, well, this afternoon. He was also a Cincinnati native, played for Cincinnati Moeller High School. 19 seasons with the Reds. He did a whole thing. Barry Larkin's my all-time favorite player, all sports. Favorite athlete. The only thing I didn't like about it, he went to Ann Arbor, played for Michigan College. And being a Buckeye fan, well, hell, you know what's up with that. But anyway, he played 19 seasons for the Reds. He was a captain for many of those years. No, exactly how many years. Dude was awesome, man. Played hurt, played. He did everything the Reds asked of him. Great player for Cincinnati Reds. Remarkable. Today he got inducted to the Hall of Fame, man. But anyway, about these Cincinnati Reds, man, they've been on fire here lately. Won 3 before the break. Then come back to the 10-game homestand after the break and won eight of ten of them, sweeping the Cardinals, sweeping the Brewers. Split 4-game set with the Diamondbacks. So far, we're 5-2 without Votto. Guys have been stepping up. Ryan Ludwig stepped up, hit the 2-run homer the other night. Or no, 3-run jack. Brandon Phillips hit it 5 RBIs against Colorado that one game. Pitching has been excellent. Palmer Bailey threw 8 innings Friday night, gave up 1 run in the 8th, struck out 10, walked none. Chapman came in, shut their asses down. I think he's, 26 of 32 before today's game. Been housed by strikeouts. Johnny Cueto, his 23-inning scoreless streak in Great American Ballpark was stopped today. Gave up 1 run. That's remarkable. Great American Ballpark. They had 74 consecutive games with a home run in Great American Ballpark was snapped today. I think Cueto, he's up around the, what was it? I don't know, like over 120 something. I'm not sure how many innings. 5 homers given up this season.
We're right back after this on 700 WLW.
About today's game, Reds won 2-1. Best thing I like about that game, in the 9th inning, 2 outs, man on second, Ron Braun up the bat. Aroldis Chapman strikes Braun out on a changeup instead of a heat. Man, I tell you, the Reds are clicking all cylinders. Unfortunately, the Pittsburgh Tie Rats are clicking on all cylinders. Them dudes don't lose. Damn, they're getting it all. They're doing it just like Cincinnati is. Great pitching, great bullpen, timely hitting. Without Votto, we're 5-2. As long as we keep that streak, I don't know. If we keep up playing ball, Cincinnati Reds are most definitely a different team with Votto. But without him so far, so good. He's up and already rehabbing. The whole rehab deal, completely different than the way they used to do. Hell, he was up walking within hours of surgery. I mean, damn. Fucking things are heating up in the Central. Reds have the most wins of the National League. Or depends what the Nationals do today. Reds got 55 wins. The Nationals got 54. Just like the Pirates. Damn, the Pirates don't lose. But anyway, just want to come on here and brag my Reds up a little bit. Mentioned Barry Larkin going into the, being enshrined into Cooperstown, which is always awesome, especially being a Cincinnati native. Man. And his speech today, after his first offseason with the Reds, Eric Davis invited him out to his home in L.A. And Larkin being 22 years old, from Cincinnati, going out to L.A. for, well, I'm sure he played the Dodgers that season, but going out to L.A. to, with a teammate at home, he thought he would go out there and party and all this, have a great time. But that very next morning after he got there, Eric Davis had Barry Larkin up at 7 a.m. running, getting a workout in. And it was more like he said spring training than anything, which I thought was pretty cool. But speaking of Eric Davis, that Pittsburgh outfielder playing right now reminds me a lot of Eric Davis. Got all the tools, man. At the catcher, he's the real deal. But that's pretty much it, everybody. Geez. Y'all be good. Peace. Later.